Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Yesterday we talked about setting up data validation, and we're frustrated that we couldn't type the first letter of an entry in order to have Excel jump there. And so today I'm going to try and use a user form. We're going to create a quick user form here. So in VBA, insert user form, and we get a form about that size. I'm going to resize it because I just need room for basically a combo box. Now let's do a couple things here. First of all, we're going to rename the form to be frmChoose. And I'm going to change the caption to choose a value. All right, now I want to add a couple of controls. The first control is a combo box. So I'll draw a combo box here. And then I need an OK button. So that'll be a command button. Draw the command button in. Of course, the caption on the command button is going to be OK. Good enough. And we want that to be the default. So that's true. Okay, now for the combo box, let's go through here. There's something called RowSource, and I already named that range. So it's sheet 1, exclamation answers. We'll have our source there. Okay, so basically what we have is we just have a little user form with a drop down and an OK button. When they press OK though, we need to have something happen. So I'm going to right click on the OK button and say view code, and I'm just going to write the value that they select right into the active cell. So ActiveCell.Value equals me.ComboBox1.Value, and then I need to hide the form, unload me. Okay, now before the podcast started, I created a short little macro here in a module that basically just says formChoose.Show, and I assign that to be Control+L. So basically, we choose any value, hit Control+L, and the dialog pops up, same list as before, but the beautiful thing is if I start to type a value, it will jump right to that value, and I can use the arrow keys to move through. I can even type a few letters. So for example, if I do CHE, it will jump to cherries, or CHI, jump to chips. And basically now I have an easy way where I can just hit Control+L and very quickly start to type a value and get that in any cell. A little bit harder to set up than validation, certainly. But it seems a lot more flexible. We could even come up with some additional code that would say, hey, depending if we're in column C, D, or E, we would provide a different list on the way in and always write that value back to the active cell. I also like this because when we set up validation, if you had 10,000 rows, we would have to copy the validation rule down 10,000 times. In this case, the control L is just going to work in whatever the active cell happens to be. Hit the value, choose the answer, and you're good to go. Well, I hope you found that helpful. If you want to learn more about VBA, of course, the book VBA and Macros for Microsoft Excel, all of this code is in there, how to create user forms and things like that. Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.